God bless you again. This is Pastor Red of Mighty Speak on Awakening Television. Today, I want to speak to the singles in the body of Christ who are not married, people who are struggling to find the right mate for their life destiny. Today, I want to talk about why you are not married and what must you do to position yourself to be hitched to find the life destiny partner that God has ordained for you. I am a bit concerned because this has allowed promiscuity in the body of Christ. A lot of single women and the single men are into a lot of activities that is profane, perverse, and is literally dimming the luminance of the glory of God in our life. But we really have to deal with it. It's so interesting that Paul makes a profound statement that for us to abstain from fornication, every woman must have their own husband, and every man must have his own wife. I kind of wonder why Paul says that, because we would have assumed that a man who has been to the third heavens will encourage that God should literally put some grace on you so you don't have no feelings or not be able to become human anymore. But he's saying that to abstain from fornication, get married. And so therefore, if the devil can thwart our effort and literally hinder and obstruct, and maybe give us some wrong doctrines that will limit, hinder, obstruct the singles to get married, then there's going to be rampant fornication in the church. And if there's fornication, then the glory of God cannot move and operate in the body of Christ. I am concerned. We are talking about, why are you not married? What are you waiting for? What must we do to be able to find a life destiny partner, that marriage from heaven, to experience the blessing, that marital bliss on earth, to literally be equipped and empowered to find the mate? I guarantee if you can listen to this, this is the year that you need to find your life partner. Are you ready for it? But before I do that, take a moment. I'll be right back. Then we can start our journey in the truth of God's word. God bless you. God bless you again. This is Awakening Television. This time, I really want to talk about, why are you not married as a Christian? Why is it that you've struggled, you have used all your seductive skills, you have manipulated, you have whined, complained, done everything possible, even invoked the name of God on your lies, and yet still nothing is happening? We want to talk about it. Why is it that you are not married? We need to talk about this, because until we deal with this issue, we can preach against lust. And because you are human, there comes a time that your defenses are broken and your restraint is quenched, and you find yourself doing things you have no right doing. You know the story of the woman out of Samaria who met Jesus Christ at the well. This woman was somebody who was interested in worship, was passionate about the right kind of worship, but because she was not married, she was sleeping around, she was with a man that she was not married to, and she was experiencing some moral challenges. Meanwhile, there was a potential of greatness in her. When Christ met her and her life was changed, she was able to win the whole city for Christ. Many of you have great potential of greatness to be revolutionaries for God, but because of your moral challenges and your struggles, it has literally handicapped. Your testimony is not real. You are living a lifestyle that is not right. We have singers sleeping with intercessors and people who are supposed to be secretaries. You become a cassetary now. You know, we don't know what you are doing. You're sleeping with the pastor. There's a whole lot of mess in our churches. And we know many of the young girls in the church are sleeping around and partying. And now we don't want nobody to talk about it. But today we need to deal with it, because I believe in you. I know there's greatness in you. Like the woman of Samaria, you can become a world changer, a global revolutionary, somebody who can literally bring a move of God. You carry something in you that we need to talk about. And so I want us to talk about, why are you not married? Are you ready for it? Let's go into the scripture to find out where we can start from the scripture to get the tools to literally put you in shape and put you in the place where God will bring the man of your dream and the woman of your destiny. Let's turn our Bibles to Proverbs chapter 18. Proverbs chapter 18, there's a text over that is so interesting. Proverbs 18 verse 22. The Bible says, whoso findeth a wife, findeth a good thing, and obtaineth favor of the Lord. Can we literally take our time to extract some points, some truths from this text? Look at the text again. Whoso found a wife. It doesn't really matter your ethnicity and your background and the challenges of life. It says, whoso found a wife. I don't care the limitations of what you don't have. If you can be positioned to find it, then you'll find a wife. Now, let's talk about the person as well, because you see, there are many people who want a wife, but they are not finding. They have not taken the moment and the time to do something to find a wife. Are you understanding what I'm talking about? It's a whoso findeth a wife. The Bible literally uses whoso. That means you cannot use your personality or the limitations of your, the challenges of life, to say that has become my handicap and my limitations that has affected me not to find the mate of my life. He said, whoso. That means God is not stressing on that. He says, whoso findeth a wife. As long as you can find that, you will come to the place of the wife. So then it is very relevant and important to get into the process of the find. Now remember, I'm going to talk about what it means to find, because the way believers are supposed to go through the process of the finding is completely different from the world. So it says, whoso findeth a wife. Now please, as a woman too, please hear me. For you to be found, you must be a wife. It is a whoso findeth a woman. You must be a wife before you get married. And so if you are a woman, then you have not positioned yourself morally and spiritually for God to get the right man that he has ordained for you to find you. So whoso findeth a wife, are you wife material? Or you a woman with seductiveness, trying to manipulate a man and connive and entangle him with your beauty into marriage. He said, whoso fanned a wife. And so if you're a woman, then you need to understand, for you to be able to get yourself into the place where you'll be found for marriage, you have to be transformed from a woman to become a wife. And when you become a wife, then it is the responsibility of God to literally bring the man to the locality of the vicinity so that you can be found. Many people in our churches are churchgoers, but they are not wife material. The mere fact that you are beautiful with a good shape does not make you wife material. The mere fact that you sing in the choir and you act spiritual doesn't make you a wife material. So then we need to define who is a wife. Because when we know who is a wife, then we can be able to tell. Now how do we know you have become a wife and you are ready for the marriage? See, the maturity of your body does not qualify you for a marriage, because you can have a good matured body and you have a little mind of a babe. You are not matured. Your attitude, your responses, and your actions shows that you are not mature. You cannot tell me that you have wife material and you're sleeping around, seducing every man you can see and acting in a behavior contrary to God. And yes, though, you say you are wife. There are many single women in our churches right now. They are not wife material. Why? Because you have not gone through the process of God yet. Now, please hear me. It says, whoso findeth a wife. How do I know you are a wife? It says, if you are a wife, when the person finds you, he will find also good. And obtaineth favor from the Lord. Now, please hear me. When the person finds you, he will find good. So then what authenticates you being a wife is not your shape. It is not anything but the good that is with you. And so a man that is going to find the wife good enough for marriage must find a wife but authenticate such a woman with good, being with her. And when we're talking about good, it's not really talking about the goodness of morality, but we're talking about the God of goodness being with the woman. Please hear me. And then when you find such a, you obtain it, as if God is giving you a diary. You obtain something. When you get such a wife, you obtain. So a man that is righteous, a man who knows what a good marriage is, he's not just going to look for a woman, but he's looking for a wife. And when he finds this wife, he also qualifies that he finds good. And when he finds good, he obtained favor from the Lord. So it is God who is giving such a woman who has become a wife to such a man. And it is God who is positioning this wife in the locality for such a man to find him. Now, if you are not a good man, you are not a man processed by God, God will never allow a woman that he has chained to be a wife to be found by you. He will not cast his pearls before swine. And so because of that, you need to understand how God is found. He says, if you find a wife, you find good. All right? Now, who is a wife? Who is a wife? Because if we find out what a wife is, it changes everything. Now, before we even go further, I want to talk about even the man who is looking. Because there's a lot of women, men in the churches right now, they are not looking for wives. They are looking for sexy women they can sleep with. They are still in the church with actual eyes, looking at the transparency of people. They are seducing women in the church, sleeping around, and yet they are busy praying for hours and screaming and shouting, and they are living immoral lives, and they are entangled with the web of fornication, and yesterday they act as if they are spiritual. I'm talking about young men and women in the church in such depravity of fornication and lust and entangled by it that they don't know what to do. Please hear me. A man that can find such a wife must be a caliber of a man that has been processed by God. Listen to me. The Bible says in Proverbs 31, it says, a virtuous woman who can find a virtuous woman who can find. Literally, God is making us aware that if you're going to have the kind of marriage that I've sanctioned, that I've ordained to release the blessings of God, then the only people who are qualified to engage in such a marriage is a virtuous woman. So if you are not a virtuous woman, as far as God is concerned, you are not good enough for marriage. You are not ready for a virtuous woman who can find. There must be a kind of man who is discerning enough to find such a woman. The morality of the man gives the woman, the man, the discernment to find such a woman. A virtuous who can find. What kind of man has paid the price to develop the senses, the discernment, the morality to give that such a man the direction to find such a woman? And such a man has his value system recalibrated by God, that he has the right evaluation system to be able to know that I am not picking a woman who is just a church goer. I'm not picking a woman just because she prays or she's a praise and worship singer. You are not going to mesmerize me with your beauty. You are not going to sweet talk me and give me some good words in my ears for me to come after you, because my value system as a man who wants the God kind of marriage is to go after a virtuous woman. And I am willing to go through the process to pay the price for such a wife of a woman. It is a man who is cheap in morality, who is going for a seductress and somebody who is talented, gifted, but doesn't have morality. And when you go after such a marriage, after such a person, then you should also know the kind of marriage you are going to get. Why is it that many people in our churches are not getting married? So let's now break it down. One, there must be some finding. There must be a process. There must be some things you have to do. And there's two, we have to know that the woman must be transformed from being a woman to become a wife. Now let's go to Genesis and we can get some information from there. In Genesis, it was God who came to Adam and he said to Adam, Adam, it's not good for you to be alone. I will make you a help meet for you. God told Adam that although you are happy in the pleasurable garden, you have everything you need, you are in pleasure, but I want to add something extraordinary to you, a wife. I'm giving you a help meet for you. Now remember, this woman that God is bringing is going to be help suitable for you. She's coming to help the man and be suitable. That means any deficiency and any limitation, anything that is lacking in the man, she's going to bring that to the table, and she's going to help her to fulfill the destiny of her, of his call. Listen to that. And God says, I will make you a helpmate. That means God is saying, I am the one who is going to make, not just create, not just form, but I will make you. That means after I've even created her, I have to go take her through a process. And when she goes through the process, by the time I bring her to you, she will be a qualified person who is an embodiment of help suitable for your call. Amen. The reason why you are marrying is not because of your longing for a partner or sexual necessity, but you are getting married not just for that. You are getting married because of the call, because of the divine mandate, because of your destiny. You need a help that God wants to bring into your life so that in that partnership you can all fulfill the purposes of God for your life. Now please hear me. The Bible declares, the moment God said that, God now sent Adam to go name the animals. God knew that in the whole world there was no woman. And yet still, he sent Adam to name the animals. And when Adam was naming the animals, he was longing among them to see whether he will find a mate. Please hear me. Why would Adam be on the assignment looking for a mate where there was no woman at all in the earth? Why will he be naming the animals and still be looking among them to see whether was somebody qualified for him? The Bible says, and he named every one of the animals, and he noticed after naming them, there was none among them that was good enough to be a partner for him. Please hear me. So therefore, Although God knew there was not a woman on the earth, the finding process was a necessary process for Adam to qualify himself to find the mate. So you understand me? If you don't go through the process of the finding, you will not be transformed to become the man good enough for the woman that God wants to give to you. So many men don't want to go through the process, but they want virtuous women. You have not changed yet. Yes, you want God to give you an angelic, somebody who is so beautiful, who loves God, who is committed, not just a church. You are literally looking for a woman who is not fit for your morality. You don't love God, but you want a woman who loves God. You don't fear God, but you want a woman who fears God. You want a woman who is spiritual, dedicated, committed. And yes, you don't have such characteristics. See, the process was going to develop something in Adam. And so it was necessary for Adam to be diligent. He has such a tenacity. He had to take his time, the patience, to name all the animals, knowing after he has named all the animals, he will not find any woman qualified for him. And yes, God allowed him to go through the process. Can I tell you that also by him responding in the assignment of God, it was also preparing him to be able to what? Know his potential, and by so doing, he was changing. When we say a man should find a wife, it does not mean that you have to keep on going through all the party places and go around looking at every woman and say that you are going on a date. That is not what God wants you to do. When God says a man should find a wife, he's telling you, engage in your assignment, respond to your call. And as you engage in the assignment, in the vicinity of your assignment, I will make sure I bring the person that God has ordained for you. Because as you respond to the assignment or the call of God for your life, you are changing. And it will come to a time that God has processed you so much the more that now you have patience, you have tenacity, you have character. You have been developed, you've matured, you call a spade, you make judgments according to the will of God. You know how to carry yourself. These processes are necessary for you to be able to have and sustain the marriage. The mere fact that you are a man, muscular, and you have all the handsomeness of a righteous man does not make you qualified to be a husband yet. Have you been processed? Have you responded to your call? Are you doing what God has ordained for you? Instead of you sitting down, waiting and wondering and figuring things out, respond to the divine assignment of God for you. Because in that way, you are changing, you are being processed, you are being going through the transformation that will prepare you for the marriage that God has ordained for you. Now, with a woman, the Bible says, and God took a rib out of the man, and then created the woman and formed the woman. But when she was formed, she was a very beautiful woman, but she was not ready yet. The Bible says, and God took her hands and then brought her to Adam. So therefore, for her to come to Adam, she has worked with God. God brought her, the woman, to Adam. By the time she got to Adam, she was not just a woman. She has become a wife. Something has happened. A wife is a woman that fears God. A wife is somebody who's gone through the process of God by walking with him. A wife is somebody who surrendered her life to God. A wife who is somebody who fears God, so she will fear the husband. A wife is somebody, is a woman who has gone through the process of God. The Bible says, God spoke to Adam, I will make you a woman. A woman made is a wife for her husband. Are you made? If you are made, where is your character? If I should examine you right now, look at the way you talk. Look at the way you behave. You are conniving and manipulative. You are insulting. You know, when you are oppressed or pressurized, look at the things that come out of your life. You are living a lifestyle, angelic in the church, but very demonic outside. You are living a lifestyle that is contrary to the morality and the standard of God. You have not been processed. The fear of God has not put you in a place where you walk in the path of holiness yet. Yeah, you talk the talk. Yes, you speak the scriptures. Yes, you preach it, but your life does not show it. You have not been made. See, when we say somebody's been made, let me give a quick example. When you have a product, we say it's made in China. And we have a product that's made in America. When you talk about made in China, you know that you're not getting quality stuff. It might look good, but it doesn't last. It's not durable. What we call durable, when we take it through the process of life and challenges, are you going to break? Your durability will be tested when we take it through stress and pressures. Yes, you are angelic. You sing well, though, but are you durable? Yes, yes, you pray for hours, but are you durable? When we take you through quality testing, how are you going to prove yourself? And we have a lot of people, they say they were made by God, but when we take them through the quality testing, they fail miserably because they are fakes. You are hypocrites. You really are not made by God. You were made spiritual. You are churched, but you are not made by God. Because if you are made by God, you are submissive, you are obedient, you fear God, you know how to treat people. The quality of your life is intact. You know how to live the life, not because you want to act spiritual before people, but the way you treat other people. If you are made by God, you will help. You are always finding opportunity to help the person that God has ordained for you. You cannot tell me your wife mature because you know how to cook and you know how to put things together, but you can't help the man that God is bringing to you. You must bring what is necessary to facilitate the life of the person that God is bringing to you. What kind of man will not want a woman who is going to help him to be great? Not just morally, spiritually, emotionally, intellectually, because that woman has equipped herself. She's gone through the process of life with God. She has walked with God. She has been with God. She fears God. She's been processed by God. She's made by God. Made in heaven for an earthly marriage. And if you can be that person, what is going to happen? The Bible says God himself will put you in the vicinity for the right man that he has ordained for you to find you. A man shall find a wife, not a woman. So it's time for you to transform from being a woman to become a wife. And for you to transform, it's not just about your beauty. Just start walking with God. Learn to spend time with God. Submit yourself to God's word, and it will change your character. You are not going to have that filthy language anymore, that insultive attitude, that manipulative attitude, that seductive look. You are not going to be wearing that kind of prostitute kind of clothes. You are not going to misbehave and act. You should not be sleeping around and living a moral, immoral life. And yes, you want a holy marriage. There's a whole lot of people in our churches right now, who can't find a mate because you are parading your sexiness. You are exuding lust. You are trying to be a seductress. You are manipulating yourself into marriage. You are trying to pressurize people and entangle them into relations. But you yourself, you are not qualified yet. And God is not going to back that up. God is God who gives a wife to a man. The Bible says houses and riches are from fathers, but a prudent woman, a prudent wife is from the Lord. Remember, you must be prudent wife before God will give you to the man. And you don't want God to process you yet. Why should he stamp on your life made in heaven? Whilst you are demonically inspired and living a lifestyle of fornication, insultiveness, lifestyle that is manipulative and deceptive, you are a hypocrite. And yes, so you want a heavenly marriage. It's not going to work. It's about time we repent and ask ourselves, what must we do? What can we do? Is there any way that we can position ourselves? The first thing we need to do, surrender yourself for the process of God. I believe that God wants to stamp on your life and call you made by God. Oh, hallelujah. When you see a woman made by God, nobody has to tell you. When you take her through the quality testing, she'll come out, not with duress, but durability. You can look at the person and say, no matter the circumstance, she's stable, established, processed by God. She has gone through the process of patience, and God has made her perfect work in her. She is somebody who is durable in morality, stable in emotions. She knows how to treat the man and carry the man with set value.